With a population of over 21 million, Mumbai is one of the most populous cities in the world. It is also the wealthiest city of India and has the highest GDP of any city in South, West or Central Asia. Mumbai has the highest number of billionaires and millionaires among all the cities in India. With one of the most vibrant film industries in the world, Mumbai is also called Maya Nagari or the City of Dreams. The city, like many others in the world, also has its underbelly of sorts, with pockets that are extremely underserved. M East Ward has the lowest human development index among all 24 municipal wards in Mumbai. According to the census of 2011, 85% of the ward's population lives in slums. The M East Ward, which forms the eastern boundary of Mumbai, is home for the city's biggest dumping ground, which receives over 4,000 metric tons of garbage every day. A number of chemical factories and refineries are situated in the same ward, while it has also been used as the hotspot for the resettlement and rehabilitation of project-affected people across Mumbai.
Millions and millions of children in our country are malnourished. Malnutrition is the biggest challenge children are facing, especially the poor, both in urban places and rural villages. The most vulnerable ones are newborns and infants.
One of the challenges of working in Shivaji Nagar is that it is located next to the Devana dumping ground, the largest and oldest dumping ground in Asia. All our efforts at improving the health of children and women become difficult to sustain because of the contaminated water and the polluted air that emanates from the dumping ground. As a result of frequent illnesses, it is difficult to keep children out of the underweight category. The residents of M East Ward are deprived of their most basic rights. Lack of safe drinking water and minimum sanitation continue to be a dream. That in this day and age, a place will have life expectancy of 39 years is unbelievable and also unforgivable.
मैं ये 30 साल से यहाँ रह रही, 35 साल से बचपना मेरा यहीं गया है. 39 नंबर में रहते थे, आज यहाँ 10 साल से रह रही है खाड़ी में. बहुत परेशानी है हम लोग को, यहाँ संडास भी नहीं है, ना पानी है और गटर भी है, कचरा दम बास आता है, सब चूल्हा जलाते हैं, धुआं खाड़ी की आती है, बहुत तकलीफ है हमारे.
Save the Children and Apnalaya took up the issue of addressing malnutrition among urban children and started working together in Shivaji Nagar since 2010. Our journey started by reaching out to the mothers, visiting them at their doorsteps and providing door-to-door counseling sessions. Our community health workers have been at the forefront of the awareness campaign on nutrition in the community. Once detected, the team of pediatric care refers the children to outpatient therapeutic program or inpatient care, depending on the severity of the case. A supplementary feeding program was introduced to educate mothers of undernourished children to prepare nutritious food at home. Infant and young child feeding education sessions are pivotal to our fight against malnutrition. We impart life-saving information about complementary feeding, hygiene and breastfeeding practices. Shivani was found to be malnourished when she came to us. On screening, doctors advised the family to go for micronutrient therapy at Sion Hospital. The community health worker motivated the family, and in 4 weeks, she was out of the severe malnutrition status. Like Shivani, Farhan, Priya, and many such children have come out of the SAM category due to the current intervention. Our collaboration with the nearest government hospital has ensured that doctors from Sion Hospital have come regularly to provide clinical support to the children in need.
मेरा नाम राबिया है, pregnant हूँ मैं और अपनाले से मेरी जांच होती है और ये pregnancy की किताब गर्भवती के लिए हमको खूब अच्छी जानकारी के लिए दिया जाता है और इससे अपनाले देती है और इससे हमें अच्छी जानकारी मिलती है हर चीज के बारे में पता चलता है क्या खाना चाहिए क्या पीना चाहिए.
Mother support groups were formed, which have played an important role in creating linkages with the nearest government health facilities.
As part of addressing child malnourishment in urban slums, our program adopts a life cycle approach. So here we work with adolescents, and the idea of working with adolescents is to tap them early, teach them, make them understand about nutrition and health practices that go a long way. So as young girls and boys, they learn what are the best practices for maternal and child health and nutrition. When they become mothers or parents, they are able to then understand how to take care of their children and avoid the pitfalls that they are seeing currently in their lifetime.
Children's groups have been at the center of the preventive approach. One-on-one sessions on life skills, street plays, and regular trainings have played a vital role in behavioral change in parents and the community. Male support groups have been formed, which spread awareness on the issue of malnutrition.
हमे कहीं से भी आने के बाद हाथ धुलना चाहिए. सब लोग मेरे साथ करो. एक, दो, तीन, चार, पांच, छः.
To address the issue of child malnutrition in urban slums, Save the Children actively promotes a community-led strategy which is known as community-based management of acute malnutrition. What you see here is a demonstration of the right ways of cooking, where the community women are trained to teach the mothers of the malnourished children to know the right ways of cooking. This is in itself a sustainable model, which is not dependent on referral systems, which is not dependent on medicines, but which is managed by the community.
Apnalaya's collaboration with Save the Children is 6 years old. It has helped the people of Shivajinagar tremendously. If we look at the malnutrition number from 2010 to 2015, we have managed to bring it down from 59% to 48%. If we look at institutional delivery, it has increased from 60% in 2010 to nearly 93% in 2015. This is just about two numbers, but in general we feel that the collaboration has helped the community because of the method or because of the approach Apnalaya has developed in conjunction with Save the Children. We seek to empower the community in terms of its ability to seek health facilities, its ability to improve health-seeking behavior, and be a responsible citizen. Because we feel that it's a combination. It's a combination of availability of facilities and
the responsibility of an individual as a citizen in terms of taking care of its health. And in both these respects, I feel that the collaboration has helped the people of Shivajinagar quite a lot.
To ensure sustainable and positive change, we all need to come together to guarantee that every last child is saved, cared for, loved, and gets basic education.
Apnalaya and Save the Children are making relentless efforts to ensure we reach every last child. We all need to come together as a joint force to tackle the issue of urban malnutrition. I stand with every last child. Will you?